Hi everyone, welcome to this new video of Azure DevOps tutorial. In few previous videos we have learned lots of things about the Azure pods. There are still some things pending, but now it's time to learn about the repo. Why we are learning about the repo? Because the further concept in Azure pods require the knowledge of Azure repo. That's why we have started learning about the repo, and now in few upcoming videos we will learn lots of things about the repo, how you will work with your code, how you will manage your check-in checkouts, all these things we will learn in few upcoming videos. So for now, let's understand what is repo and what are the version controls. Let's start. Let's have a look on the agenda of this video. In this video, we will learn what is repo, what is version control, what is the use of repo, who should use repo, and what are the types of version control in repo. It means what different type of version controls are available in Azure repo. That we will learn in this video. First thing first, let's understand what is repo. So repo means repository. You can say either repo or repository, both are same thing. In very basic terms, a repo or repository is a container which is used to store and manage your code in a systematic way. Since we are talking about the Azure repo, so this container, this repo is available on the server of Azure DevOps, and all your code, your entire code with all the details about all the changes in that code is available in Azure repo. In other words, repo is a version control tool which is used to manage code. So what is this version control? Let's understand about version control first. Version control systems are a type of software. Basically, version controls are also a type of software which are used to track and manage each and every change in the code. What happens when an entire team or an individual is working on a particular project on a daily basis, he makes some changes in the code, and if you want to know what change is done by whom, then all these things are managed by the version control. Multiple team members or an individual can work in a very efficient manner if you are working with the version control system. Version control is a must-use software to manage your code. If you are working on any type of project, if you have a code or if you have some data related to that particular project, then you must use version control. What is the use of Azure repo? To store the code of a project. In every project, we have some code, and to store that particular code, we use Azure repo. Track and manage each and every change done in the code by the team. All the team members can work on code without any issue. So what is happening here, we have a common container for all the developers, and all the members in a team can work on that particular common container without having any issue. The merging of the code is done very easily, and all these are handled by the version control. You can create several copies of your code. It means, so suppose one person is working on a particular feature which is called authentication. Second person is working on a particular feature which is something related to the payment system. All the developers can create several copies using the branching system, and all those developers can work independently on their own branches. If you are not using version control, what is the problem you face? So suppose you have made some changes in the code, and now your code is ready for the production deployment. So what you did, you just deployed the code on the production, but for the backup kind of thing, you want to store that code in your file system. So what will happen, you will just create a new copy of your code and you will save it at a particular place in your system. Again, after the new sprint, when it's time to deploy the code on the production, then you will again create a copy of your code, and again you will save the entire code in a separate place. So basically, with each build, you are creating lots of copies of your code and you are storing all those copies in your system. So this is also wasting the memory. If you are using version control, then there is no need to create multiple copies for each build. You can handle all these things using the tag feature, which is provided by the version control. And there are lot of other benefits which are available in the Azure repo if you are using version control. All these things we will learn in upcoming videos. Now the question is, who should use repo? Everyone who has some data related to a project. What is the meaning of data? The data means code. You can have code for a particular project, you can have few files, you can have reports, you can have images. All these things can be managed with the help of Azure repo. If an individual is working on a project, then he or she also must use version control. So generally the thinking of people is, since only a single developer is working on a project and he thinks he does not need the version control. But I recommend you, if you are working even individually on a particular project, then you must use version control. Every team to manage their code. All the team members should use Azure repo to manage their code. Scrum Master can also use Azure repo when he wants to track their changes in the report. So all these things can be managed by the Scrum Master also. Same PO as well. PO can also use Azure repo to track all the changes which are happening in the reports or other documents which are beneficial for the Scrum Master or the PO. Let's understand what different type of version control are available in Azure repo. In Azure repo, there are two types of version control. What are that? First one is Git, the most popular version control which is used in today's software development. Second one is TFVC, Team Foundation Version Control. And I have written some text in front of these version controls. First one is Distributed Version Control. And the second one, TFVC, is Centralized Version Control System. What is the difference in these things? What should you use in your project? How will you identify which one should you use for your own development? That we will learn in the next part of this tutorial. That is all for now. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.